140th game and rocking the Houston throwbacks tonight. He will look to lead the Cougars to an 8th consecutive win, all coming off the heels of that loss at home against Memphis a couple of weeks ago. Don Daly, Byron Jarrett, and Jeb Hartness are officials tonight. The tip won by Houston, rocking those sweet throwbacks at home as Jamal Shedd controls for the Cougars. 25-4 on the season. Only two losses in the American Conference at SMU, home to Memphis. They've been ranked the entire year, dating back to last season. A school record. This program with great tradition. 43 consecutive weeks in the top 25.
27, you're already looking ahead.
I am looking ahead. They'll get to 27 at some point. Not going to be tonight, but they might get one closer as Tajay Moore opens the scoring for Houston. And here is the starting five for Aaron McKee's Temple Owls. Surprising starting five. Emmanuel Okpomo makes his first Temple start. And some great guard play of late. Miller, Strickland, and their leading scorer, Damian Dunn, one of the Americans' most surprising teams.
Very, very young, but very, very tough, this Temple bunch.
Dunn blocked by Fabian White Jr., who's got 16 blocks in the last six games. It'll be Temple ball with one to shoot. Another impact play made by White. That'll be a quick one. It is from Dunn, who got it off just in time, apparently, and the rebound collected by Houston and Moore. Here is the starting five for the Cougars. It's the usual suspects. White, Carlton, a potential first-team all-conference. Biggs, Edwards, the Texas Tech transfer. Tajay Moore, the Cal State Bakersfield transfer. Both honored on senior night. And the American assist leader, Jamal Shedd, runs the point. Good active hands here to take away. Okpomo out of the ball screen and a block shot by Moore. A fantastic recovery, and Houston has a block on each of the first two possessions.
Now, Tajay Moore has emerged defensively as dominant as he just tracks it down and goes up and gets it. A tremendous athlete who never gives up on a play. He has flourished in the system under Kelvin Sampson.
And here's Shedd contesting the inbound. Out of bounds, it is off Temple. A Temple turnover and a Houston takeaway as the Cougars' typical tenacious defense is on display.
Now, Kevin, on Tuesday night, the Houston Cougars beat the Cincinnati Bearcats and clinched the championship in the American, but Kelvin Sampson decided they would not cut down the nets. They thought it would be disrespectful to Temple to do that, but they're planning a party tonight if they can win this one, and they will cut the nets down if they can be victorious at home tonight.
Carlton is fouled inside, and for Kelvin Sampson's team, it is the third time in 4 years that at least won a share of that American championship. And the year they didn't was last year when they won conference tournament, made the Final Four. There's been a lot of net cutting around these parts of late. Carlton the rebound off the white miss, and Josh Carlton, who's lived at the free throw line this week, will shoot two. That is the resume for Kelvin Sampson. Second Final Four last season, first in nearly two decades. And you and I have had a lot of Houston games this year. You've been around Kelvin Sampson a lot, Mark. 33 years as head coach. Why do you think this head coaching job is as good as any in his 33 years?
Because of the roster situation that he took care of when Marcus Sasser went down. Arguably the player of the year in the conference, certainly in the preseason. And then lost Tremont Mark, who also is their first team all-conference type player. And he went from being a ball screen offense to an inside-out offense to Josh Carlton basically overnight. The way he re-engineered this roster and turned it into one of the elite teams, not just in the league, but in the country, it's his best coaching job of a bunch of great coaching jobs for Kelvin Sampson.
Is Temple in possession after missed three by Shedd? Got another offensive rebound. Arashma Parks is into the game for Temple. Okpomo, a couple of quick fouls. And there's a miss by Dunn, and Temple is 0 for 3 to start against the nation's best field goal percentage defense.
And Josh Carlton hasn't even touched the ball down the paint. There he is on the perimeter. They usually like to run inside out to number 25, Josh Carlton.
Tyler Edwards controlling. Houston's leading scorer, nearly 14 a game. This is White. It's White. It's silky smooth, continuing what's been the greatest on-court week of Fabian White Jr.'s college life.
You know, Kevin, I have said that Kendrick Davis is the player of the year in the American. I got to tell you, I'm starting to flip a coin between him and Fabian White Jr., the way this kid is played coming down the stretch.
It is a two-horse race right now, I think. Kelvin Sampson said this week, if you win the league, the best player on your team should be seriously considered. Right now, that's Fabian White. There's a block shot by Moore, rejecting Strickland, and Temple turns it over to Shedd, and here's the high flyer. Timeout, Aaron McKee. Houston off to the races in its home finale.
The late lady traveled with Grace, baby. I can't afford to cover the course of... Just because the seasoning and flow's already active. 24 years, you classic.
Every home should be a haven. IKEA.
Take a look at the energy, the execution of this Houston defense. How they react to the ball, how they help out. Watch Kyler Edwards come from behind. And there is the strip, and there's the loose ball. And all of a sudden, Houston off to the races for Tajay Moore with the dunk. And this team defensively, it's their unscripted offense that makes them so effective, either on the offensive boards or defensively getting it out and going. That's why Houston is so hard to guard.
They are not a great shooting team, and yet they are 10th in the country in adjusted offensive efficiency because of the way they rebound, because of the way they turn defense into offense, and Temple turns it over for a second time here on an illegal screen. So the Cougars will get another extra possession. And extra possessions, Mark, are the name of the game for Kelvin Sampson's teams.
The unscripted basketball by Houston is what coaches worry about the most. The turnovers that lead to breakouts. The second chance points where Josh Carlton goes the offensive glass. Fabian White goes the offensive glass. Tajay Moore. And it is just a convention around the rim every time a shot goes up.
Foul was on Parks, his first, and then Parks gets a takeaway and a poor pass by Edwards. Temple looking for its first bucket in transition, and Sage Tolbert comes up short. Carlton runs the floor, and nobody runs with him. Houston has the first dime.
Josh Carlton came to this program at 270 pounds. Now he's 240 pounds and sprints the floor. He no longer jogs or runs the floor. Number 25 in white sprints the floor.
Great word between Carlton and their strength coach, Alan Bishop. And here's another illegal screen against Parks. He's got two fouls to join the other big man, Okpomo. Boy, this is a nightmare start for Temple. A dream start at home for Houston.
Hustle plays. That's what Houston is known for. They get out and go on the offensive opportunities off their defense. And Josh Carlton, big fella, just sprints. Reminds me of Robert Parrish.
The magic is calling you to stay at a Disney Resort hotel, where you're surrounded by the world's most magical celebration. The fun never stops. Special friends greet you. You soar to adventures with extra time in any of the four theme parks every day. And now, you can save on rooms at select Disney Resort hotels. Why would you stay anywhere else?
Our journey at Continental has taken us down many roads. And when we first started, they weren't even paved. For more than 150 years, we've worked hard to earn your trust. From the trail to the racetrack and beyond. The Continental Mark in all its forms stands for confidence. Confidence you trust. Continental Tire.
The best part about doing things yourself? It's free. Like doing your own taxes with H&R Block free online, where more people can file free than with TurboTax. Help is here.
This is your invitation to experience all the feelings inspired by Lexus at the Invitation to Lexus sales event.
Get special offers on the 2022 ES350.
Did you know that with the Sonic app, it's always happy hour? As long as you order your drink on the app.
All this time I've been hoping and wishing and dreaming I could have just downloaded the app.
Or yeah. Upset because you missed
it. Oh, because I missed it? Ending business meetings to make
all
it?
All you had to do was pull up your phone.
I was done.
A lot of people assume coaches are looking at plays on that clipboard.
Just like they assume they can't afford great insurance. But State Farm has rates that fit any budget.
And those aren't plays that read.
It's an 8-letter word for charcuterie. I like it.
For surprisingly great rates that fit any budget, like a good neighbor, State Farm is there. Call or click to get a quote today.
ESPN's exclusive presentation of college basketball is brought to you by the Sonic Bacon on Bacon Quarter Pound Double Cheeseburger for a limited time only at Sonic. Najee Moore, Josh Carlton, their second senior nights, their transfers, Kyler Edwards and Fabian White Jr. with their first senior nights. Special night for this special group of Houston players, student managers as well. And they've contributed to another incredible season for Houston, leading the country in opposing field goal percentage, one of the best rebounding teams, one of the best shot-blocking teams in the country. Despite the major injuries, which we've talked about all year, those four players in particular, Carlton White, the bigs, Moore and Edwards, the guards, have been four out of the five starters on this team, along with the sophomore Schiff.
And part of that unselfish culture is right there off the pass, the assist to Tajay Moore to Jamal Shedd. First 20th in the country with over 16 assists a game.
And Moore, one of their best assist leaders, only three a game as he picks up the one there for Shedd. Temple 0 for 5, three turnovers and make it four. They've not scored in nine possessions to start.
This beckons back to the East Carolina game when the Pirates only had eight field goals and Houston had nine block shots for the entire game.
Somehow Houston only has credit for two blocks right now. It feels like they could have one or two more. But Temple is 0 for 5 right now, and the Owls have gone to Nick Jourdain and Zach Hicks along with Khalil White off the bench. Very good young players who spurred on this surprising season. That's a tough shot for White, and a rebound to Shedd. Houston is plus four early on the glass. There's Shedd, the assist leader in the American, who had 11 of those on Sunday against SMU. Moore, inside Edwards, ducks in and is fouled by Miller. Free throws coming for Kyler Edwards on Temple's fifth team foul. And Houston, by the way, has not committed a single foul.
Tajay Moore just keeps getting better and better. In double figures, eight out of the last nine games. For three assists during that time. Double figure score. I mean, Aaron McKee is having a tough time matchup along with everybody else in the American with Tajay Moore.
Final Saturday of the regular season in 2 days, maybe our best lineup yet. Saturday's showcase starts at noon Eastern. Arkansas and Tennessee, two teams that could be around the four seed line, maybe get higher as well. The SEC, that's noon Eastern, 11 Central. Texas and Kansas at 4 Eastern in the Big 12. And then Coach K's swan song at Cameron Indoor Stadium. UNC Duke at a Sonic Blockbuster, 6 Eastern, 5 Central, all on ESPN. Meanwhile, Fabian White, another offensive rebound, another basket. It's 15-0 in the first 6 minutes and change.
Houston's just playing harder. It's really that simple. They are dominating on both ends of the floor.
Mark, this is Houston's third game in 5 days. They're in a stretch of four games in 8 days. You would never know it by the way Houston's playing. Maybe some teams, after winning a conference title 2 days ago, would have an emotional letdown. But Houston has been, if anything, even better than they were and even more energetic than they were a couple of days ago as Temple finally gets on the board with a three from Jordan.
Now, there aren't many emotional letdowns for Kelvin Sampson coach teams. And I've seen it firsthand. You come with your lunch pail and your work boots or you're not going to play. It's real simple. It's his way or the highway. And he is maniacally focused on getting his teams to the heart. And they do.
White tripped by White. The Leo fouls Fabian. And Houston will be in a bonus for the rest of the half. Inside to Fabian White. He scores again.
Easy.
An early 6 points for Fabian White Jr.
Now that's just way too easy. That's a total breakdown and not following the game plan. I mean, Temple, they went through out of bounds plays. We know that. But that's just lack of preparation on the defensive end.
Jordan fouled and finishes through the contact. Nick Jordan has all five for Temple and can make it all six.
Now, Nick Jordan has been one of the positives for Aaron McKee. McKee talked today about everybody wants everything to happen right now, but it takes time for players to come together, to learn how to play together. But Nick Jordan has been one of those positive stories at 6'5", 205 pounds, and he struggled to make shots at times. We had 23 at Tulsa. He's very versatile, hard to guard, going to do nothing but get better.
Second in the conference in blocked shots. And Jordan with all six as White gets his first breather. Juwan Roberts into the game. He's played very well off the bench of late for Houston. Reggie Chaney and Ramon Walker are also in off the Cougar bench. This is Chaney. And that is a turnover. Behind the back for White from Jordan. And an offensive foul going against Jaleel White. He's the third Temple player now to pick up two fouls in the first half.
Watch what Tajay Moore does. Forces the extra pass because Jordan knows he's going to get a block and then just steps right in to take the charge. Either way the ball went, Tajay Moore was going to make the play.
Temple has hit one shot and they've committed three offensive fouls. It's not the blocks versus makes of ECU a couple of weeks ago, but it is a notable number. Carlton got all out of whack, got it back, and got rejected by Jordan, the league's second-best shot blocker. White trying to step inside, and a blocking foul will go against Houston and Jamal Shedd.
Now one thing about playing Houston, you better come in ready to play with a big chip on your shoulder. And Temple's learning that right now. This is a young basketball team that's done nothing but get better under Aaron McKee. Let's see if they can settle them out and knock down some shots. Nicely done.
That's the guy you want to get it to. Zach Hicks, their best shooter. And despite the absolute nightmare of a start, this Temple, back within nine, with a long way to go.
It's a really good IQ guy. Really, really smart.
Roberts inside on Hicks. Blocked again. Jordan came over to help. That's his second. Then Houston commits a foul. Temple has emerged into the game after a dreadful start. A long way to go. The Owls will have the ball when we return.
Will remain radioactive for years to come. Well, thank goodness, it's time for the good news of the week.
And boy, do we need it.
Well, this safe driver saved money with the Snapshot app from Progressive. How do you feel?
Good.
He's better than good. He got rewarded for driving safe and driving less.
Sorry, Barb, just to confirm, this is the feel-good news of the week?
This is what we found.
Yay, Snapshot.
Welcome to the McLaren Formula One Q&A.
Does anyone have any questions?
Yes.
Yes.
Hi, Zach. Can we meet Lando?
Can we bring Lando on stage?
Hi, everyone. It's Lando.
It's Lando.
Lando, who has the best fans? England, Germany, or France?
I don't know. What do you guys think?
Let's put up a poll.
Come on, England.
Germany.
With WebEx, McLaren F1 team fans get even closer.
Let's go racing.
Introducing the WebEx Suite, driving hybrid work.
I am so pumped to be back with you guys for March Madness.
You remember the first time we got together?
Good seat, Sam. I used my Capital One Quicksilver card and earned 1.5% cash back.
I don't know what that is, but it sounds cool.
Come on, Red!
Sorry, I'll never do that again. Promise.
Hello, friends.
You knew about the Quicksilver card back then?
It's called being a visionary, Chuck.
Sam, you've always been ahead of the game.
I need thinking big.
All the flame-grilled stacker saucy Big King taste you love is now on the
2-4-5
for a limited time.
Sure feels good when you get it right. And with the number one power toothbrush brand recommended by dental professionals, Philips Sonicare makes it easy for you to always get brushing right.
A decade of power performance.
And a vision for a powerful future. This is the American Athletic Conference.
You guys ready for this madness?
ESPN Tournament Challenge. Sign up now.
It's an 8-2 run for Temple, which is clawed back in the game here. Owls are once again without their starting point guard, Jeremiah Williams, who's missed four of the last five with a shoulder injury. Jake Forrester still out with a non-COVID illness, was their starting center at the beginning of the season. It's the second youngest team by experience. Mark, Ken Pomeroy measures that. His wonderful stats website. Only Dayton is a less experienced team in college basketball. To have a team this young improve this much, a really great job by Aaron McKee this year.
And Damian Dunn is a shot maker during big time situations for this Temple team. That's why they've won so many close games. They've won 9 American Athletic Conference games by an average of 5 points per game. You usually don't do that with the second youngest roster in the country. But Aaron McKee has helped them to focus on doing the little things, being aggressive, keeping their eye on each other and looking out for each other. And I really think he's done just a tremendous job with this young roster.
Strickland was stripped on the way up with 4 to shoot. It's not a great non-conference for Temple, but after a 5-11 season last year, a slow non-conference this year, they played well in league play, and one of the officials has reversed that from an out-of-bounds to a 2-shot foul. So Ty Strickland, 69% free throw shooter, will take 2.
And Ty Strickland came up huge. And Damian Dunn was not available against SMU. Aaron McKee had to pull a rabbit out of the hat that game. Now, in fairness, SMU didn't have Kendrick Davis. But Ty Strickland went for 27 in that game, so they didn't have Jeremiah Williams, who's not playing tonight, really good athlete, versatile player. They didn't have Forrester. They didn't have Battle. And they didn't have Dunn. And they still figured out a way to beat SMU. Why? Because Ty Strickland took over the scoring role. They had 27 points in that big victory over the Mustangs. That was a heck of a win for this young team.
And Temple now 1-1 away from clinching a first-round bye. Top 5 teams get it next week in the league tournament. Edwards over the top of the backboard. Houston has missed its last 4 shots, and the run is now 9-2 for Temple.
This Temple team plays more like a John Chaney team than any team I've seen in a long, long time. They're young, they're tough, they're together, they compete. Here they come.
Hicks with a 3. He's got 5 off the bench, and it's 9 in a row now for Temple.
In the last 7, he's averaged almost 13 points a game. Jack Hicks has been critical. This young team excelling. They're coming down the stretch. Give their last 4.
Houston started 7 for 10 before these 4 missed shots in a row. And nearly turned it over there. Moore way off on a 3. Carlton is there, and Carlton is fouled. looked like Jordan was in the mix there. And it'll be Jordan's first personal foul.
I asked Josh Carlton, one thing about him nobody knows, he told me he played the cello as a kid.
I knew that. You didn't know that?
No, I didn't know that.
No, I did not know that either. But we'll get back to the cello in a second. Because I have to tell you about some NBA players that I don't think play the cello. DeMar DeRozan and Giannis, Bulls, Bucks. Maybe they're cellists. I don't know.
Might be.
7:30 Eastern, then the Knicks against the West leading Suns at 10 Eastern, 9 Central. NBA Countdown starts it off. 7 Eastern, 6 Central, ESPN and the ESPN app. You can hold the Carlton thought because we have a teaser. You've teased his favorite song. And you've told us it'll be an interesting choice as Carlton picks up the steal for Houston. Moore has it knocked away, and a pickpocket for Temple ends up in the hands of Jaleel White. White taking it in the shed. Jordan is there. He couldn't get it up cleanly, but instead he'll go to the line, drawing a foul against Carlton, and that's the second on the Houston big man.
So, Kevin, have you ever heard hot cross buns?
Yeah, I love hot cross buns.
Mr. Mercer, Ryan. That's his favorite song. He's a cellist. Hot cross buns.
His favorite song to play?
That's his favorite song to play. He can also sing it. Yes, can I? Hot cross buns. Hot cross buns.
But can you play it on the cello?
Penny, hot cross buns. No, but I can sing it.
Okay. Well, that remains to be seen or remains to be heard. Jordan, 2-for-2 at the line for Temple.
I did that.
I'm sure there's an extended version somewhere.
There is. You can look it up. Like the accomplished cellist, Josh Carr.
There you go. And his final regular season home game after a great career at UConn. This Houston team only up 4 right now. Carlton on the bench with those 2 fouls. White is back in.
Look how Temple sagging. They're just begging Houston to take a 3-point shot.
And Hicks with great defense on Shedd. Out of bounds off of Jamal Shedd. And the Owls have a chance to make this a one possession game.
Really good job moving the feet. Temple right now is sagging so much. That's why they're taking away dribble penetration. They are daring Houston to shoot the ball from 3-point land.
And Houston has really struggled from 3 of late as Jordan sloppily turns it over. Moore with a howitzer down the court to Edwards.
Nolan Ryan like.
Back to White. He's been the man this week. Roberts battling for the offensive rebound, and Jordan took it away. Houston crowd wanted to travel. They may have a righteous point there. Kelvin Sampson is still signaling for it.
Well, if this young Temple team can stay together, this is championship quality basketball team. They're going to be really good.
Gun from Jordan. Left it short on a 3. Edwards snatches the rebound from his teammate Moore.
Watch Temple how they defend to the 3-point line. Watch how they're packing it in. They don't want to give up inside shots. They want to give up contested 2s and long 3s. There's the contested 2.
White misses. Roberts rebounds. Houston 1 point in the last 9 possessions. Back into White. Finally, Fabian White unlocks the scoring.
With all those black jerseys hanging around the paint, you got to double team that.
White with 21 on Sunday against SMU in the win that basically clinched the conference championship, a career high 28 Tuesday in the game that officially did it. Done yet to score. Temple's leading scorer is 0-for-3. Lost it on the way up. Edwards pushing for Houston. Inside to Moore. Timeout Temple. And Aaron McKee immediately out in the face of Damian Dunn after Moore cut right to the Houston hoop.
Huh. 15 minutes could save you 15% or more in car insurance.
Hey, I know that.
Well, did you know that former pro football player Icky Woods will celebrate almost anything?
Number 44.
Woo! 44, that's me!
Get some cold cuts, get some cold cuts, get some cold cuts.
Woo! Give me some!
Geico, 15 minutes could save you 15% or more on car insurance.
44, ladies, that's me! Woo! Go get some cold cuts today!
This is your invitation to experience all the feelings inspired by Lexus at the Invitation to Lexus sales event.
With four strips of crispy bacon and rich melty cheese and two juicy charbroil patties, of course no meeting can compete with this meat. Give in to the new Double Bacon Beast Burger at Carl's Jr. and Hardee's and feed your happy.
The best part about doing things yourself? It's free. Like doing your own taxes with H&R Block Free Online, where more people can file free than with TurboTax. Help is here.
Thanks a lot for all the support. First of all, it's KRZYZEWSKI.
Every day I had an opportunity to be with the best.
He's been as good as anybody who's ever coached this game.
These folks.
Monster Energy AMA Supercross Championship. See the world's elite motocross riders race for the series points lead.
Are you ready? It's time to bring the action. Let's do it.
Be there to see who wins the round at Lumen Field.
Oh, they're going for it.
Holy cow.
I cannot believe what I just saw.
Don't miss Monster Energy Supercross action. Coming to Lumen Field March 26th. Tickets on sale now. Visit supercrosslive.com for more info and get your tickets today.
1-877 cars for kids.
Now accepting donations of land, homes, buildings, or any kind of real estate.
The hardest thing to teach a young team is to communicate on defense. Watch, Damian Dunn, number one, Nick Jourdain, number 11. And they're lined up, but nobody talks. Nobody says anything. And Tajay Moore runs right between them and goes in for the easy layup. Watch Aaron McKee. He goes ballistic coming off the bench because Damian Dunn knows better, has to communicate, and believe me, Jourdain is going to get his backside chewed as soon as Coach McKee sees this video coming up tomorrow morning.
It's a young team, as we mentioned. It's the second youngest team by experience in the country, and Aaron McKee told us before the game, they're just so young. Every day, somebody needs attention, and his attention was directly delivered to Damian Dunn there. Temple has used two first half timeouts and trails by eight at the Fertitta Center.
Getting players to communicate, play together. That's the hardest to teach to a young team.
Good look for Hicks, his second three of the game. 8 points, 3 of 3 shooting for Zach Hicks, who continues to step up for Temple.
Now, Zach Hicks has blossomed.
And a game of 10 threes against Delaware State this year. Since then, has been one of the best three-point shooters in the American. This is White. That's a missed three. And Ramon Walker just out-hustled everybody for the Houston rebound.
That's what he does. He just out-hustles everybody all the time.
Elwood Samson's motto is be first team all-conference in your role. This guy is too. Roberts with a ferocity inside.
Remember, he hit the game winner in double overtime at Wichita State. Just step into the rim. Juwan Roberts keeps it simple and finishes easy plays.
Second chance points for Houston, which has 7 offensive rebounds. Temple, 7 defensive rebounds. Strickland, a clean look. Strickland short. Rebound to Walker. Beg your pardon,
good ball
Roberts.
Movement by, good ball movement by Temple. Love that possession.
Chen. Edwards barely recovered. White will drive. White will score. White will have a chance for a hard-earned three.
Fabian White gives this team swagger. This guy has just figured out that he can shoot it, he can drive it, he can rebound it. That's the swagger of Fabian White.
Mark, this is the 141st game of Fabian White's Houston career. And talk about peaking at the right time. Games 139 and 140, maybe his two best in a Cougars jersey. And 141 is shaping up to be a dandy, too. He's got 11 points in 12 minutes.
I said 3 years ago he'd end up being one of the all-time greats at Houston. And he is.
Ordain fouled for Temple. Talked to Kelvin Sampson about Fabian White yesterday. He said, for me, he is in the Mount Rushmore in this program. Not necessarily the best players, though. Kelvin said he doesn't have to make any excuses for his talent level. But when you think about the accomplishments at the University of Houston, when you think about the growth of this program from Hoffman's Pavilion to a year at Texas Southern to the Fertitta Center, Kelvin said Fabian White can touch almost everything we've done. Most wins, most games played in Houston history. He'll be a first-team all-conference player for sure, if not more. Whether his jersey will end up there, who knows, but he is now in an elite list at the University of Houston. Shed, in and out. And Walker, another offensive rebound. Edwards missed it. Who's going to get it? Walker's in there again. White as well. White is on the deck. So is Walker, and Temple emerges with it. Finally.
Five jerseys on the deck. Three black, two white. Welcome to the American tonight.
And Roberts with a rejection. Third block shot for Houston.
This is the most blue-collar league in the country. Period.
This is a Ringo Starr kind of league. It don't come easy, especially not against these guys. As White is blocked, somehow the ball is kept in by Jaleel White, and he missed the layup.
It ain't always pretty, but it's fun.
That was pretty for Houston. Fabian White with 13. Shed with his fourth assist.
Houston thrives in this environment. They want chaos.
Jordan to White. Got Fabian White up in the air and scores. First bucket for Jaleel White, the freshman from Whitesboro, New Jersey.
Well, that basket calmed this crowd down right away. These players are gassed. Look at them just walking up the floor. They are gassed. And remember, Houston doesn't have great depth. That's their Achilles heel.
Fabian White. Austin on the way up. Jaleel White, who scored the last bucket. He loses it. Strickland will finish for Temple. Kind of wonder, I know it's the under four timeout coming soon. Wonder if Kelvin Sampson, and he is going to call a timeout right there because of how gassed those players look. Third game in 5 days for Houston. Fabian White Jr. trying to go out on top. 13 points in the first half. The winningest player in Cougar history.
Well, the Houston Cougars might be gassed. They got enough gas in their tank for this. Fabian White, one of the all-time greats, is a Houston Cougar.
We've got to tell people that Liberty Mutual customizes car insurance, so you only pay for what you need. And we've got to do it fast.
Woo! New personal record, Limu!
Only pay for what you need.
Liberty, 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 Liberty.
With my hectic life, you'd think retirement would be the last thing on my mind. Thankfully, Voya provides comprehensive solutions and shows me how to get the most out of my workplace benefits. Voya helps me feel like I got it all under control.
Voya. Well planned, well invested, well protected.
Weird. Come on. Great. You for real?
Ah! So maybe just a cable?
We can help you.
Welcome to America's number one battery destination, AutoZone, your battery solution. Take the west side, take on the east. I'ma put them in a cage, never let out the lock. I am Jack with the boys. Can't stop for the talking. I am Jack with the boys. Not so tough, but man's be fucking. Just too sharp with the prize. Like the hell tell me I'm awesome, yeah. Just too sharp with the prize. Let's go tell me I'm awesome, yeah. Hell tell me I'm awesome. Hell tell me I'm awesome, yeah. Hot like fire on a pan. If you wanna touch my feet, use caution.
Your mission, stand up to moderate to severe rheumatoid arthritis and take it on with Rinvoq. Rinvoq, a once-daily pill, can dramatically improve symptoms. Rinvoq helps tame pain, stiffness, swelling, and for some, Rinvoq can even significantly reduce RA fatigue. That's Rinvoq relief. With RA, your overactive immune system attacks your joints. Rinvoq regulates it to help stop the attack.
Rinvoq can lower your ability to fight infections, including TB, serious infections and blood clots, some fatal, cancers, including lymphoma and skin cancer, death, heart attack, stroke, and tears in the stomach or intestines occurred. People 50 and older with at least one heart disease risk factor have higher risks. Don't take if allergic to Rinvoq, as serious reactions can occur. Tell your doctor if you are or may become pregnant.
Talk to your rheumatologist about Rinvoq relief. Rinvoq, make it your mission. Learn how AbbVie could help you save on Rinvoq.
The best thing to order is when you are sitting at soccer practice, order it through your phone while you're sitting there, and then you go and pick it up.
But you're much more of a planner than me.
I am.
And that's what I love about you.
Yes.
You know, I'm not that prepared. It's more seat in my pants.
Fabian White Jr., a career high 28 points two nights ago. He is nearly halfway there in the first half.
We're looking at what he does around the basket, where he has a highly refined game. Kellen Sampson works with the fours on a regular basis, and Fabian White has had that opportunity to work with Kellen Sampson now for all of his career. He's gotten better and better. But where he's made the biggest improvement is from the three-point line. He's got great lift fake. He's got really good legs that just pogo into his jump shot. He's got a good, simple release on that three-point shot. And because he does that so well, he goes inside and can pound people inside as well. This kid's going to play in the NBA because he's such a well-rounded competitor. That's the key, competitor.
Well-deserved breather for him right now. Robbie Armbrester is into the game for Houston, who almost never sees time in the first half. And Armbrester fighting for a rebound that's won by Temple. And it was Strickland who got on the floor for the Owls.
Now, this team is gassed right now. And Temple needs to take advantage of that right now. Late in the half is when you can make a move on Houston. And Aaron McKee has used his bench wisely in this game. And they've been very productive off the bench.
18 to 21 points have come from the Temple bench. That's an offensive foul. Drive by Damian Dunn. That's Temple's fourth offensive foul to the first half.
Now, Robbie Armbruster came off the bench and filled his role right there defensively. Just went straight up and took a shot with the chops.
Armbruster, 12 games this year, 1.3 points per game. Number two on the baseline right now. Again, third game in 5 days. Kelvin Sampson just trying to steal some minutes.
And remember, this team goes and plays Memphis this weekend as well.
Mm-hmm. Here's Armbruster from Moore, and a slam for Robbie.
Energy on the defensive end, energy on the offensive end. Number two, Armbruster, doing his job.
Strickland misses a three, and a foul will go against Houston.
Look at Armbruster, just gets behind the defense. Look how everybody's ball-centric. All the eyes of the Temple Owls are focused on the basketball. Armbruster sees it, just continues to move along the baseline and steps to the open space. Nick Jourdain again, defensively. He's pointing, but he's not communicating. The hardest thing to teach a young team is to communicate and to locate. Armbruster takes advantage of that young defense.
And this is a kid they never thought would play this year, with Marcus Sasser coming back, with Jermon Mark returning to the team. Those two, of course, are hurt. You have Edwards, you have Shed. Ramon Walker was supposed to redshirt. And here's Armbruster, who's a raw, athletic kid, getting some minutes in the first half. He's picked up a rebound. He's got a dunk. Houston has 8 baskets at the rim right now. Four dunks, four layups, and Armbrester had the last one of them.
When the ball goes up, watch number two go to the offensive glass. He is hungry for some playing time. But here's where you earn it.
Shed a jumper.
There he goes.
Didn't need it that time. Jamal Shed with 5 points, four assists as well. The lead stretched to a dozen in a game that Houston led 15 to nothing. Bourdain into Armbrester. Good defense by Armbrester, forced a tough shot. Edwards, three. Last touch by Jourdain. Again, Armbrester was in there. I mean, he's in every play right now. And look, when you play three games in five days, the kid who hasn't played much, he should have the most energy in his legs.
Yeah, Robbie Armbrester, I measure hustle through a Focus app. Robbie Armbrester would be a guy right now who's grading out at 100%. He's 100% going to the offensive glass. Doesn't mean he gets an offensive rebound. It means that he goes hard. Defensively, he's down a stance. He's pressuring the ball. He's in good defensive guarding position. He's been 100% in that area. Robbie Armbrester's doing his job because he is hustling the right way.
Jaleel White with a finish around Walker. 4 points for Jaleel White. And Houston will slow it down in the final minute of the first half.
And for Kessel, just make a stand here, go down and score. Just keep it in the hand. Hang in. It's the depth of Houston that can be exposed to the sand. For lack thereof.
Roberts. Armbrester. Inside. Tough shot. Edwards saves it. And a shot clock, I don't think, should have reset there. I don't think that Armbrester shot hit the rim. It did reset. And then Roberts ended up getting fouled. Maybe he would have got the shot off before shot clock anyway. Let's take a look. That didn't hit the rim.
Didn't look like it from that angle.
Again, maybe Roberts would have gotten that off. Couldn't tell in real time before the shot clock would have ended either way. And he misses the first free throw, so we're halfway to a ball don't lie situation.
Exactly right. Basketball gods, will they shine down upon the Owls of Temple right now?
Foul is against Jourdain. That's a big one. That's his second. Roberts misses both. Walker cleans it up. It's ridiculous.
Now, Walker's the other guy that just brings hustle, just makes winning plays coming off the bench.
Houston 10 offensive rebounds, Temple 11 defensive. First game, Houston had more than Temple defensively. Jed, no good. Last shot of the half will not come in time. And Houston will jog or crawl into the locker room with the lead in their tired legs. They will bring in Okomo as starter along with Dunn, Miller, and Strickland, though Jourdain begins the second half on the floor. Same starting five for Houston. Cougars have already clinched the one seed in the American. Temple can clinch a first-round bye with a win. They can still finish as high as third or as low as sixth. Damian Dunn could not get the layup to fall. It was a recurring theme for Temple in the first half, but Dunn will shoot two. And the foul on Josh Carlton. And that's going to be Carlton's third foul, just 16 seconds into this half.
A really smart play by Damian Dunn to recognize that and go right at Carlton along the baseline.
Fourth best free throw shooter in the American, and a rare miss for Dunn.
Well, Kevin, the stat that really stood out to me is the Temple of the bench scoring. 20 points off the bench. This is a young team that lost their leading scorer and their best back-to-the-basket player, arguably, Jake Forrester. But Aaron McKee has been able to figure out who can come in and help this team and score points coming off the bench. He's developed depth. A lot of coaches give up on depth right around January 1st. He's developed depth and broadened his bench.
And no bench points meant that Dunn did not score. That was his first point, that free throw. White battling for the Moore miss, and Houston has rebounded almost half of its missed shots in the game. 11 of 19 more than a half, actually, and they get another one. Carlton throws it on the rim, and it's out of bounds off of Carlton to Temple.
Three guys pack the glass on every shot, and they are relentless. They just don't take one step to the rim. They sprint to the rim. They are just so active and aggressive on the offensive glass. They have been for years under Kelvin Sampson. Houston's best offense is just throw it up and go get it.
There's Jourdain with a good first half for Temple. 8 points, 4 rebounds, 2 blocks. Now Dunn, 6th leading scorer in the conference, just 1 point in the game. Inside to Jourdain. Carlton with a 3, fouls on him, and Jourdain scores to cut the lead to 7.
With crafty move by Nick Jourdain, as Josh Carlton was building the fence around the basket, just went to the backside to protect the shot with the rim. Well done.
Temple started the second half on an 8-0 run Sunday in its last game, beat Tulane. This is more from Carlton. Good pass. Carlton crashes, and Carlton is fouled. You see the hands, you see the touch of Carlton, then you see the relentless drive mark on the offensive glass.
They just keep going and going and going. You know, so many fans just watch the ball. Don't watch the ball when it goes up. Just watch Josh Carlton, Fabian White, Tajay Moore. Watch those three guys go to the offensive glass. 35 in white, 25 in white, 4 in white. Just watch them go.
Their best offensive rebounding rate in the country for Houston as Carlton sinks the first. And Carlton splits the pair. Asir Miller brings it up for Temple. Owls without Jeremiah Williams again today. Miller making a 6th consecutive start. No Jake Forrester, no Caleb Battle. He's been out since early in the year. Jourdain bricks a 3. Jamal Shedd with a Houston rebound.
And no Jeremiah Williams. A versatile, rangy athlete not available for Aaron McKee. Good player.
Hoping to have him back by the end of the season. He's been a game-time decision for a couple of days now with a shoulder issue. Jake Forrester has been out with an illness, was dressed today, but has not played. Houston's only hit 1 3, and Shedd makes it 2. Off the fine from Edwards.
Damian Dunn wants the ball. He's hunting his shot right now.
Around Edwards. Dunn with his first made field goal.
Yeah, he used Edwards on that play. He just went right to the rim. Edwards looked tired defensively on that play. You've got to wear Houston down to have a chance.
Hard to blame him if he is tired. Leads him in 33 minutes played per game.
Yep.
White. Back-to-back threes for Houston. They hit 1 triple in the first half. They hit 3s on consecutive possessions in the second.
Well, Temple's been daring them to take the 3, and it's worked out up till now. The Shedd and Fabian White start to heat up from downtown.
White with 16. Jourdain, a step on White. He gave it up. He could have gone into Carlton with the 3 fouls. Instead, Miller misses a 2. And then Miller chases it down, hands off to Dunn, who sticks it around Carlton.
3 white jerseys around the ball. Didn't get it. Didn't hustle. That's unusual for Houston. Out hustled on that play by Temple.
Shedd to Carlton. And Carlton fouled again. And if this is Jourdain, it's his 3rd. We'll wait to see who it is when we return. Houston finally hot from the outside after 1-3 in the first half. Shedd, then White to extend the Cougar lead.
My English teacher in 4th grade, she used to get really upset with me. She's like, Nico, when you're writing these papers, you can't use the word stuff. But there's no other word to describe besides stuff. There's just a bunch of stuff in here.
Sonic Double Stuff Oreo Waffle Cone and Blast.
Double things Oreo Blast? No.
You're probably wondering, what makes these chips taste so good? Here's a hint. It's lime. They taste like lime.
Tostitos. Get to the good stuff.
You hit the road if we're going to beat the traffic.
All right.
Maybe we'll just beat the traffic tomorrow?
Here's my dip.
Yes, sweet!
Did you bring your Chevrolet dip?
Yeah, but it's just 7 layers of beans.
Resourceful! Or did you invite all your friends to watch your favorite team?
They're losing, but that's okay.
So sweet, so you need. Baby, there's nothing better. I bet you've probably done something that deserves a Dr. Pepper. Did you pretend to like sports like your girlfriend's dad would like you better?
What? No, I love sports.
Me too.
Everyone's done something that deserves a Dr. Pepper.
So with Geico, we can easily bundle home and car insurance and save even more?
Yeah, home, car, motorcycle, all bundled together. Just like that breakfast burrito.
So can I get chorizo?
Metaphorically, yeah.
Carnita.
Just chicken. Just give me a bunch of chicken.
Oh, bacon?
Wait, there isn't too much hot sauce, is there? I have a sensitive palate.
I actually like hot sauce. Can I get chips?
How about guacamole?
I don't really know what we're talking about anymore.
Burritos.
Sure. Okay.
For bundling made easy, go to geico.com.
Your mission, stand up to moderate to severe rheumatoid arthritis and take it on with Rinvoq. Rinvoq, a once-daily pill, can dramatically improve symptoms. Rinvoq helps tame pain, stiffness, swelling, and for some, Rinvoq can even significantly reduce RA fatigue. That's Rinvoq relief. With RA, your overactive immune system attacks your joints. Rinvoq regulates it to help stop the attack.
Rinvoq can lower your ability to fight infections, including TB, serious infections and blood clots, some fatal, cancers, including lymphoma and skin cancer, death, heart attack, stroke, and tears in the stomach or intestines occurred. People 50 and older with at least one heart disease risk factor have higher risks. Don't take if allergic to Rinvoq, as serious reactions can occur. Tell your doctor if you are or may become pregnant.
Talk to your rheumatologist about Rinvoq relief. Rinvoq, make it your mission. Learn how AbbVie could help you save on Rinvoq.
How about some Enthusiasm American Awards? Kelvin Sampson's not only the coach of the year in the conference, he's the coach of the year in the country. Kendrick Davis, why is he my pick for player of the year? Because of the four games played against Memphis and Houston. They won three out of those four, and Kendrick Davis averaged over 22 points per game in those games. Most improved, Temple. They combined for 10 wins over the last two seasons. They've now won 9, and what a job Ron Hunter has done with Tulane. And the most improved player in the American Athletic Conference is Josh Carlton. He didn't even average 4 points and 4 rebounds for the UConn Huskies. Now he does that for the Houston Cougars.
Carlton with 7 points, 7 rebounds today. Houston's lead is a dozen. 4 years at Connecticut. The grad transfer to Houston, they knew they wanted him. Kelvin Sampson said he called him 3 or 4 times right when he saw Carlton in the portal. This is going to be an offensive foul against Jourdain. He picked up the foul going to break, and Jourdain has just picked up his 4th as Walker draws the charge. And a technical foul's been issued as well as Jourdain barreled over Walker. The call was a charge. What do you think?
It was hard to tell how quick that went with Ramon Walker. Let's take a look right there. He establishes his defensive guarding position, takes a flush on the chest. And this is what Ramon Walker does. He just makes hustle plays, and Jourdain has a problem right there with the call and fouls out on a technical foul. Young team, right? Sometimes guys make mistakes. Nick Jourdain just made a mistake, and now he'll sit the rest of the game.
So he was given the technical foul. That is the 5th on Jourdain. He had 2 fouls right before he went to break. He committed a defensive foul, an offensive foul, and a technical foul in succession. White misses the free throws, but now it is going to be a long, long sit for Nick Jourdain. 5 fouls for Temple. For a young player who scored 10 points in this game in 18 minutes.
A really good player, went for 23 at Tulsa. And this kid can play. And now Aaron McKee will probably just go small ball.
3 fouls in 25 seconds for Nick Jourdain. his night done. This is Tajay Moore off to Carlton. And another finish at the rim. That ball was going in. Goaltending, and Carlton has 9-7.
Yeah, Houston recognizes that Jourdain is out of the game now. So what are they going to do? They are going to pound it inside. I mean, this is just ABC basketball, and the C stands for Carlton. Get it to him inside.
What do the A and the B stand for?
Always... I haven't thought about that yet, but I'll get back to you.
Yeah. Always basketball, Carlton. Not quite
assist,
Gary Glenn Ross.
Assist plus bigs equals Carlton. How about that?
Well, yeah, well, there's a plus. That starts with the letter P. I don't know how you can justify that one. Foul is on Shed, his second.
A plus is a symbol. It's a symbol. Look in your camera right now. I'm giving you the symbol. Okay.
We can't air that. It could be a difficult sign to see
it. I know you can see it.
Hey, final Saturday of the regular season in 2 days. Great triple header basketball. Wonderful games all day. Arkansas, Tennessee, an awesome SEC matchup to kick it off at noon Eastern, 11 Central. 4 o'clock Eastern, it's Texas and number 6 Kansas. And then, of course, Coach K's last stand, his final regular season game at Cameron against North Carolina. It is a Sonic blockbuster at 6 Eastern, 5 Central. Duke winning the ACC regular season championship the first time in more than a decade. And they look to build on their seeding against UNC.
Think about the pressure on those on the Duke basketball team. Here's Mike Krzyzewski's last home game in front of the Cameron Crazies. And they've got to win this game against their arch rival. There's a lot of pressure on those players to step up and get that done. Now, I think they will. But, man, a legend is leaving the building, and you've got to win for him.
There's a foul as Colbert took it up. By the way, the last foul against Houston was the fourth on Josh Carlton. So... 5 fouls against Jourdain for Temple, but Carlton has to sit right now for Houston after he'd been cooking in the paint. That last foul's on Tajay Moore, and that is his third. So Sage Tolbert shoots 2.
And Houston's been so effective on the offensive glass. But they don't have to go any harder, but they're going to double down on the offensive glass now. Temple's running out of big bodies.
Colbert at 6'8", 210 is the nominal 5 right now. Temple within 11. Still trying to hang around on a floor where Houston's gone 59-4 in a year since the opening of the Fertitta Center. Chet. Good drive, good finish. 10 points for Jamal Shipp.
He's one of the best 2-foot jump stop point guards I've seen in a long time. Just fundamentally sound.
Here's Jaleel White. Roberts bows him up. Dunn will be fouled by Edwards. A reach in for his second, and the fouls are starting to pile up for Houston.
Watch Jamal Shedd. 2-foot jump stop, right? There. Really balanced. Goes up strong. He's as good at that. That's a lost art among a lot of players. I love the 2-foot jump stop because he's so balanced and so powerful out of that stance with the 2-foot jump stop. Well done by Jamal Shedd.
Why is that a lost art?
A lot of coaches don't teach it as much, and they don't demand it as much. Once upon a time, point guards did 2-foot jump stop on the full court opportunities in the break. You don't see it anymore stopping the free throw line. Tajay Moore from downtown. That wasn't a 2-foot jump stop. That was a really good jump shot.
Moore with 9 points. Largest lead for Houston at 16. Strickland somehow found a player. It made its way out to White from Tolbert, and then Jaleel White gets bumped by Fabian White. Second foul on Houston senior.
Well, Kevin, what's interesting about this Houston team, we've talked a lot about their depth, and they're going to be tested at Memphis, believe me. They're just going to keep bringing, Penny Hardaway is going to keep bringing waves of bodies at this team. But what has really been interesting to me, especially over the last five, six games on their winning streak now, is that they pull away in the second half. They don't seem to get tired. If they do, it's out of reach anyway, because they're just hammering people in the second half.
So against SMU on Sunday, SMU cut the lead through just a couple of possessions. Houston pulled away. Saw it against Cincinnati on Tuesday.
Yep.
It was a one-point game. Tajay Moore hit a three at the halftime buzzer, and then Houston went on a 22-9 run to start the second half. You wonder, when are they going to tire out with eight players? And usually they don't, and that's because of the work that Houston puts in practices and at shoot-arounds, which frankly look like other teams' practices.
But they just go so hard. I mean, even the managers run lines for Kelvin Sampson. That's how hard they work to get ready. A manager literally wasn't paying enough attention in practice the other day. He ran line drills.
Edwards, end of the shot clock, well short. And Temple grabs it right before the shot clock was about to expire. Temple shooting at just 36.7%. It's the nation's best field goal defense. Owls, not a typically good shooting offensive team, have had trouble tonight, and they have trouble there. White denies Strickland.
Fabian White, you are selling me. Kendrick Davis, I put him down as the player of the year. Hey, what? He is right there. He's playing the best basketball of his life right now.
Roberts this time, and a late whistle is in. Second foul on Roberts. It was almost a sixth Houston block. And free throws coming for Tolbert, who hit his first two.
Well, Temple got behind early in the first half, couldn't score at all, but they just battled and battled and battled. And that's why I say they're a lot like a John Chaney team. They go on the road, they do their thing. This is a young basketball team that continues to get better. Let's see if they've got a run in late in this game.
A lot of close games, wins and losses in conference play. Right now, Temple a half game ahead of Tulane and UCF. Two of those three teams will get a first round bye. One will have to win four games in 4 days to play in the American next week. Off the missed three by Fabian White. Temple with Strickland. Down by 13 on the road. They have South Florida in the regular season finale. They'd like to come back and seal that bye right here. And they're going back to the line as Roberts commits his third foul. Eight fouls and a half on Houston. Temple trying to claw back.
And it's easy to get a quote at libertymutual.com, so you only pay for what you need.
Isn't that right, Limu?
Limu? Sorry, one sec.
Yes.
Oh, boy.
Only pay for what you need.
Liberty, 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 liberty.
I need you to see.
Celebrate every kiss that led to this one. Get 20 to 40% off engagement, wedding, and anniversary rings at K.
Having a 5G phone that's not on T-Mobile makes as much sense as playing ice hockey. Using pool noodles. Get out of the penalty box with 5G coverage like this. T-Mobile has more 5G bars in more places than anyone. T-Mobile, more 5G bars in more places. Another reason T-Mobile is the leader in 5G.
It's time to start your own business.
to turn your dream into something official. LegalZoom has helped launch and support millions of small businesses. Start an LLC, corporation, or nonprofit with LegalZoom. Let's make it official.
The Capital One Saver Card, baby. 4% cash back on dining and entertainment.
Rewarding Chuck for dining and entertainment?
So he does.
That's like rewarding me every time I use a curse word.
It's like rewarding me every time I say hello, friends.
Like rewarding me for every time I plunder.
Hey, Garth, thanks for the goat cheese.
Don't thank me. Thank her.
This goat cheese is from that goat?
What's in your wallet?
Whoa, 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 hold up there, partner. That's my line now.
Tell him, Sam. Tell him who's the goat.
Let's make a toast to doing more this spring. Actually, let's make two. Introducing creamy hummus and savory avocado toasts. Topped with oven-roasted tomatoes, vine-ripened, and perfectly seasoned. Now you have two more delicious reasons to do your thing this spring. America runs on Dunkin'.
The best part about doing things yourself? It's free. Like doing your own taxes with H&R Block Free Online, where more people can file free than with TurboTax. Help is here.
Jamal Shedd is an artist. The basketball court is his canvas. Sweet stroke from downtown. Jamal Shedd, creative, how he attacks the glass. And creative off the floor as well, as during COVID, during the summer, he would do yoga and then paint with his mother every single day. For some of the abstract art that you see by Jamal Shedd. He loves doing that. It's the way that he connects with his brother and with his mother. It's become part of their routine now as a family to do it together and be creative. What do you think, Kevin?
I think there's a little Starry Night in that photo. Some hints of Van Gogh, would you say?
You know, you just moved to Baltimore into a new house. I think I could talk to Jamal and get you one of his paintings that you could actually hang in your home.
I would love that.
If interested, let me know.
All right, you do that for me. I'm game. I will.
It'll
take
cost $1,000. It's $1,000.
Wait,
and I get a certain fee off of that for representing Jamal tonight on the air.
I hope this is all non-binding.
But thank you.
I just want to be clear. I didn't read the subtext before you began that journey. Here's another offensive foul. I will commit if you can get the price down to 950. That's another offensive foul against Temple, by the way, which is at least six in the game.
Yeah. Yeah, that's not a basketball play. That's a clear out play. 950. Sold!
You going to talk with Jamal first? You going to make this decision on his behalf while he's playing?
No, he's giving me permission to go ahead and make the sale. With the NIL, I have now become an art broker for Jamal.
Okay.
Smith.
This is good. You finally found your calling. It's taken a long time. Coach didn't work. Broadcaster. Art broker is going to be your thing. There's White, and 18 points now for Fabian White Jr. Two away from a third straight 20-point game. There's a three for Jahlil White. Why'd you say uh-oh?
That's a bad shot right there. And he was left open for a reason. And it looked like that would be a breakout for Houston. Didn't work out that way, but that wasn't a very good shot.
He's a 21% three-point shooter, White. Inside to White. He wants it again. Fabian going to work. Black jerseys all over him. Missed the shot. Roberts playing volleyball with himself, and it's out of bounds to Temple.
Well, it's 15, and now this young Temple basketball team, one possession at a time against this maniacal defense of Kelvin Sampson.
Temple's last 6 points have come at the line. No field goals in the last 6 minutes. Dunn, crazy pass out of bounds, and Temple's turned it over a dozen times. That's four turnovers for Dunn. He turned it over seven times in the first meeting with Houston. And when you throw that kind of pass,
yep,
you get a seat on Aaron McKee's bench.
Yep. And Aaron McKee is not normally a guy that's going to dwell on the negative and sit a guy down, but in that task, you've got to do something.
And was forced, essentially. More turnovers than made field goals for Temple. Moore, foul, but a chance for three. Tajay Moore pumping up the crowd in his final home game of his six-year career. He can extend the lead to 18.
You know, once upon a time, Tajay Moore on every play would make someone happy. Sometimes in a Houston jersey, sometimes in the opponent's jersey. He's become so much more consistent. He's been adding to his basketball IQ throughout the season and continues to make better decisions as the season rolls along.
Moore, in a story in one of the local papers, he's from South Haven, Mississippi, outside of Memphis. He said, I thought I'd work at a factory. I thought I'd be the world's most athletic Amazon worker. Went to Bakersfield, had a good career there, but a ton of injuries. Has come to Houston and really found a home and played major minutes after the injuries early in the year. Out of bounds. This is Houston ball. Turnover number 13 for Temple.
Tajay Moore is a guy that needs encouragement. He needs parameters to play within, but he needs constant positive reinforcement. And one thing Kelvin Sampson does, he really reads his players well. He knows when to put the hammer down and when to put his arm around him. And Tajay Moore is one of those guys that you better put an arm around him more than you lay the hammer down.
Moore lays the hammer on Temple. A three for Tajay Moore.
Yeah, when he gets rolling in a positive direction, it just rolls downhill for Tajay Moore.
For the final time this season, the Fertitta Center is as electric as any building in this city.
There are two kinds of players, energy suckers and energy givers. Tajay Moore, you are an energy giver tonight in Houston.
This is your invitation to experience all the feelings inspired by Lexus at the Invitation to Lexus sales event.
Get special offers on the 2022 ES350.
Sure feels good when you get it right. And with the number one power toothbrush brand recommended by dental professionals, Philips Sonicare makes it easy for you to always get brushing right. Philips.
There goes my heart beating, 'cause you are the reason. I'd climb every mountain and swim every ocean.
Kiss the people you love. Mark this moment in time and celebrate every kiss. Get zero down special financing with the K Jewelers credit card.
What if your resume could adapt and improve? Even create opportunities that let you be seen. An Indeed resume never stops working for you.
Baby, it's over.
I mean, we both saw this coming.
What a difference a day makes.
Weird. Come on. Great. You for real?
So maybe just a cable?
We can help you.
Welcome to America's number one battery destination, AutoZone, your battery solution.
Real cowboys get customized car insurance with Liberty Mutual, so we only pay for what we need.
Hey, Tex, can someone else get a turn?
Yeah, hang on, I'm about to break my own record.
Only pay for what you need.
Liberty, 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 Liberty.
This is a Filet-O-Fish sandwich. These are Arby's 2-for-6 crispy and spicy fish sandwiches. So, see you soon then. Arby's, we have the meat.
Sean and Zubin in the studio. Arizona two games away from completing a perfect season at the McHale Center, Sean.
You want to know what a Pac-12 player of the year looks like? Looks like that guy right there, Benedict Mathurin. What a season he has had for Tommy Lloyd. They could be the best team out west. It could be an all-west Final Four national championship with the Zags and the Wildcats.
And college basketball live scoreboard to follow the game, fellas.
Gentlemen, thank you. Excited to see what chapter Benedict Mathurin adds to a masterpiece of a season, Tommy Lloyd's first at Arizona.
Now, Benedict Mathurin is a fascinating story. He was a multi-sport athlete. He played football and ice hockey. His 15-year-old brother, as we take a look at the dunk here by Kyler Edwards, his 15-year-old brother died tragically in a bicycle accident when Benedict was 12 years old. So he used that as inspiration to actually play basketball after he was 12 years old. And now, Kevin, I've watched him a couple times here recently. I'm telling you right now, this kid, right now in his career, reminds me of Michael Jordan when Jordan played at North Carolina. No-look passes, offensive rebounds, 6'6", runs the floor like a gazelle, a refined mid-range game. Look, this kid's going to be drafted somewhere between 5 and 10. Somebody's going to look back 10 years from now, they're going to say, why on God's green earth did we not draft Benedict Mathurin? He is special, I'm telling you. Mark it down right now. Save this tape. Let's come back and visit in about 10 years.
All right, because you just threw out the GOAT. So this is a tape to mark down. You're giving Benedict Mathurin the college MJ comparison. I want to make sure that you're logging into that, because that's a bold tape
into
by
it.
You. All right.
Now, he's obviously going to have to improve. I'm telling you, I watched Michael Jordan in 1982 in the Superdome in the national championship game, and Benjamin Mathurin looked just like him at the same time of their careers.
All right. Well, if that wasn't enough reason to watch Arizona Stanford, then there will be no reason to watch Arizona Stanford. Wildcats ranked second in the country. That game coming up right after this. It was poked away by Temple, so no backcourt. Five to shoot for Shedd. Out to White. 4-3.
Going to make another prediction. The Nets and the Fertitta Center are coming down tonight.
Three consecutive 20-point games for White. First time in his career he's done that, in the 139th, 140th, and 141st games of his career. His first stretch with back-to-back-to-back 20-point games. Shedd. Edwards all alone. Look it. A deflection. Here comes Shedd again. Off the backboard to Moore. And the teams have to be separated. You do not want to see this. This is the last thing you want to see if you're Houston, with emotions running high. A scuffle between the teams after the dunk by Moore. Temple timeout on the floor. It'll be hard to cut the Nets down if there's no roof on the building.
Magic is calling you to stay at a Disney Resort Hotel, where you're surrounded by the world's most magical celebration. The fun never stops. Special friends greet you. You soar to adventures with extra time in any of the four theme parks every day. And now you can save on rooms at select Disney Resort hotels. Why would you stay anywhere else?
People assume these photo shoots are easy.
Just like they assume they can't afford great insurance. But State Farm has rates that fit any budget.
Four,
What?
Can I get a profile?
All in the core.
A surprisingly great race to fit any budget? Like a good neighbor, State Farm is there. Call or click to get a quote today.
With crispy bacon and fluffy eggs and melty cheese. Oh, Beast Mode doesn't have to stop for breakfast. Give in to the new Bacon Beast breakfast menu at Carl's Jr. and Hardee's and feed your happy.
Hi, I'm Wolf.
It's amazing.
He's talking about motorcycle insurance, and people love it. Of course, they love the savings they're going to get with Geico, but it goes beyond that.
You deserve to save.
Heard that before.
You deserve to save.
I know.
I need you to hear me. You deserve to save.
I deserve to save.
I mean, he has a way of making you feel seen.
Bundle car and motorcycle insurance and save at geico.com.
Here we go.
All the best in sports.
He's gone.
Yeah, you've got it.
He's gone.
Time to celebrate.
All your favorite teams? Just find your squads, and we'll do the recording for you, so you never have to sweat.
Oh, this is going to be a big night.
All the biggest games, we found them for you. Just tune to Channel 205.
What a catch!
Can't stay home? Take your games with you. And the most live sports in 4K HDR, including the most NBA games in 4K.
Unbelievable!
DirecTV, we do sports.
This was the last play before the break. Jamal Shedd. Dramatic alley-oop to Tajay Moore. The building rocking. You see Miller and White up. You see Parks and Moore going at it. A shove from Rashman Parks. Parks has been assessed a technical foul. Moore as well. So Parks' fourth foul, Moore's third foul. Little bit chippy. Temple had called a timeout, so there are no technical fouls for players leaving the bench because play had been stopped. Emotions running high. You can understand that to a degree because this is Houston's final home game. The building is rocking, and they're 7 minutes away or so from cutting down the nets with another American championship.
Well, it's March. It always gets a little chippy around March, especially when you're playing a team for the second time. Of course, Houston won that game in a close game up in Temple. This is a young team, up-and-coming team that's trying to prove themselves. And Ross Parks a little bit too physical with Tajay Moore and got banged with the technical foul.
So both players are going to take a seat.
Yep.
Cool off a little bit. Now, Houston will get the ball back after the technical fouls. And Houston leads this game by 29 points. They won the title on Tuesday. They said they weren't going to cut the nets down until after the game Thursday. It'll be a feel-good ceremony right now as Robbie Armbrester dunks for the second time in the game.
Well, there's just a party going on in Houston right now. They didn't cut down the nets after the win versus Cincinnati and decided they were going to wait for after the Temple game. Looks like there's going to be a lot of cutting going on in Houston.
The run is 20-2 over the last 4:18. Houston has 14 baskets at the rim tonight, Mark. Temple has 11 baskets from anywhere.
Well, remember, against East Carolina earlier this season, East Carolina came to Houston and scored 8 baskets total for the game. Houston had 9 blocked shots. They had more blocked shots than their opponents had baskets.
Lil White needs a clean basketball. Byron Jarrett plays ball boy for a moment. Temple has just stopped hitting field goals. Their last 9 points have come from the free throw line. They've not hit on the field in a drought of nearly 10 minutes. Right now, the last 9:48, and White only goes 1-for-2 here. We're coming on nearly half of a half, Mark, without Temple hitting a shot to the floor.
I asked Aaron McKee today in one word to describe Houston. He said aggressive. And then he said, our team, what's so important is that we don't blink. Because when you blink, it's a 20-2 run.
Hicks. A close. Well, if not blinking is what you want to see, the eyelids of Temple have about the pace of the St. Joseph's Hawk right now. Shed.
Hawk never dies.
Carlton! And Houston never stops. It's a 32-point lead in the Fertitta Center finale 2022.
Boy, this is just a drubbing.
This is a Temple team that's exceeded all expectations this year, that played Houston tough a couple of months ago, lost by only five at home. They've hung tough with about everybody in the league. This is another level of basketball. Everybody, it seems, besides Memphis, for the most part, has seen it when they've come into this building this year. Houston is 17-1 at home. And they finally allow a field goal, first in over 10 minutes, over 11 minutes, actually. Jaleel White over Fabian White. Temple's first make from the field in 11-plus minutes.
And Kevin, that one loss was to the Memphis Tigers. And guess who the Cougars play next? The Memphis Tigers in Memphis. Memphis clearly, squarely on the bubble, as per Joe Lunardi. It's a huge game for Memphis.
It will not be as meaningful for a game as Houston, but they, I'm sure, will play like it is just as meaningful, even though they've clinched the number one seed. Right now for Houston, it's you're battling for NCAA tournament position. They're right around the four or the five lines. But they're playing like every game is their championship. And another takeaway. 18 turnovers for Temple. White with the stuff from Edwards. And the runaway train continues apace.
So there is one reason why it's a big game for Houston. They're 0-3 against quad one opponents. This is a quad one game in Memphis. That's the only question mark on their tournament resume right now. There's a party going on in Houston, Texas. These are the champions of the American dominating.
Why don't you do cool spins?
People need to read it.
I can't read it.
It's because you're like four.
Half.
Switch to Progressive and you can save hundreds. You know, like the sign says.
Tostitos avocado salsa. You put all of this in here so you can put it on, well, just about anything. Tostitos avocado salsa. Get to the good stuff.
I may be close to retirement, but I'm as busy as ever. Careful now.
Thanks.
You got it. And thanks to Voya, I'm confident about my future.
Oh, Dad, the twins are now...
Vegan, I know. I got him some of those plant burgers.
Nice.
Yeah. Voya provides guidance for the right investments and helps me be prepared for unexpected events. They make me feel like I've got it all under control. Because I do.
Okay, that was awesome. Voya, be confident to and through retirement.
Check out this Verbo.
Oh, now, look at me. Here I am. Right where I belong. It's all I've been looking for and so much more. And now I'm here. Now you're here. Nothing can go wrong because I am right where I belong.
Like they've just
ASMR.
We're pulling internet out of your room.
Sonic double stuff Oreo waffle cone and blast.
You're getting cut off.
The best part about doing things yourself? It's free. Like doing your own taxes with H&R Block Free Online, where more people can file free than with TurboTax. Help is here.
you look at Coach K, he's one of the best coaches of all time.
Coach K has had such a huge influence on so many people's lives.
Lives he impacted and the standard he set, that's what Coach K was all about. Thank you.
Centerpiece of Saturday's incredible sports day on our family of networks, ABC, 3 Eastern, the Blackhawks and the Flyers. Carolina Duke, Coach K's final regular season game, maybe his final matchup with UNC, depending on the ACC tournament, at 6 Eastern, 5 Central. Warriors-Lakers in primetime in UFC 272 to follow that. It has been all Houston tonight from a 15-0 lead to start the game to a 32-point lead here. Held Temple without a field goal for 11 minutes, 19 seconds of game time. Nearly 24 minutes of real time. For a Temple fan, you could have watched an entire DVR episode of Jeopardy come back, and your team would not have hit from the field in that time. What is one heck of a defensive performance by Houston as Moore adds his 18th and 19th points?
Temple's going to learn from this experience. There's a lot of lessons here. None of them easy. None of them fun. But this team's going to learn from this talent-laden, experienced basketball team how you compete.
Another steal for Fabian White in Houston. White in his final game at the Petita Center has got 23 points, 5 rebounds, 2 steals, 1 block. He's only 5 away from his career high, which he scored 2 days ago. Moore, why not? Rebound to Temple. Pretty soon you'll see the slew of senior night substitutions, certainly, Mark. All 4 seniors, Edwards, Carlton, Moore, and White, are in the game right now for Kelvin Sampson.
Well, that's assuming that Kelvin Sampson has enough players on his bench to sub him out.
He's going to get one going here, call a timeout. He's got 2 remaining. And Ramon Walker will come on, and we'll see who comes up. Tajay Moore is the first to depart. The first of what will be, we expect, 4 standing ovations from the Houston crowd. A young man who had 5 surgeries on his leg, fractured tibia and fibula at Cal State Bakersfield. The 3rd and final grad transfer Houston took this year, or just transfer period. And a lot of options for that spot. They went with Moore. It was the right choice. White for 3.
We are watching history right now. Fabian White, greatest winner in the history of the Houston program.
Block shot, Carlton, and then a foul. And Fabian White, Mark, 2 nights after the highest scoring game of his career in game 140, has the 2nd highest scoring game of his career right now in game 141. There is no greater testament in college basketball than that young man to the power of player development.
Fabian White went through an ACL injury and retaught himself how to shoot the basketball. As Josh Carlton now comes out of the game, the guy who was an enigma at UConn, at times was wrapped in an invisibility blanket, and he transfers to Houston. He's anything but invisible now. He is the go-to guy. He is the focal point of this Houston offense inside the paint. Josh Carlton, what a season for the most improved player in the American.
Carlton fouls out, ends his final night with Houston with 11 points, 8 rebounds in just 19 minutes. Edwards and White probably be next. Kyler Edwards does have another year of eligibility left, but it is his senior night, and he's going to cap it with a 3 because everybody's capping their senior nights right now for Houston. 8 threes for the Cougars in the second half.
You're going to go out on senior night, you're going to go out with a championship. You're going to go out with a championship and a drubbing.
I mean, you've coached senior nights before. You want to pick the spots to get your players recognition. I'm sure you've been in some 2-3-point games where you can't really do that. Kelvin Sampson can take his time and run out the assembly line here as Ryan Elvin's going to substitute into the game, the Houston walk-on. And it will be for Edwards.
Tyler Edwards, when Marcus Sasser went down, they needed someone to step up as a scorer. And Tyler Edwards answered the bell, defensively and offensively.
He was supposed to miss 4 to 6 weeks with a sprained ankle earlier in the year. He missed one game. Leads the team in minutes played. And he takes a seat. We'll see if he's back for Houston next year, but Edwards with a degree, honored on this senior night. And now there is one man standing for the Houston Cougars. That's the winningest player in program history. And his moment is nigh. Fabian White Jr., the Atascocita kid. The two highest scoring games of his career and his two home finales. And the crowd will take it from here.
He is the product of proud parents. His mother, Andrea, is the engineer of a train that hauls dangerous chemicals. His father is a supply chain manager who provides those chemicals for that train, for that engineer. This is a family that is just a tremendous testament to what parenting is all about. And this young man represents his family, the city of Houston, the university, with nothing but class. The winningest player in the history of Houston basketball. Not Elvin Hayes, not Hakeem Olajuwon, not Clyde Drexler. It's Fabian White Jr.
Fabian White tore his ACL in May of 2020. He returned in February of 2021. That is a freakishly fast recovery by any standards. To do it while the world was in a global pandemic only adds to the extraordinary nature of that situation. Elvin Sampson said today, it's one of the most selfless acts of any player I've ever coached, the ability to come back that quickly. Elvin! Oh my goodness! The bench is bonkers because the walk-on Ryan Elvin has put his name into the scorebook. One final basket for Tolbert and Temple. They may not sleep until Sunday, these folks in Houston. One game left in the regular season, but the seniors end their home career.